So let's talk about null. Because you cannot imagine programming without it. We need null, right? For example, you're building a blog, and that's a classic example. I know a blog post can be a draft or published, and only when it's been published will it have a publication date. So naturally, the publication date must be a nullable field, right? Okay, let's first discuss the problem with null, and then we'll talk about solutions. So whenever a variable can be something or null, in our blog post example, that's a datetime object or null, when that happens, you are forced to take two possibilities into account. Either you're dealing with a datetime object or you're dealing with null. And that has implications because you cannot call the date format function on null, but you can on a datetime object. And so you end up writing lots of checks and conditions to guard against invalid method calls. So I would say there are two problems to solve. First, by using null, you must write quite a lot of boring code, boilerplate, that's necessary to be sure that your program won't crash when dealing with null. No one likes that. But more importantly, second, there's always this annoying feeling in the back of your head. Am I dealing with a nullable variable here? Do I need to add an extra null check? And I find that feeling, that uncertainty, to be a burden when programming. It increases cognitive load. The possibility of null forces me to be on guard and to focus on issues that distract me from my actual goal. So these two problems with null are amongst the reasons why I like stricter type systems. If I can avoid the possibility of null within a function or a class by using proper types, then I will do so because it reduces that cognitive load. For example, a blog post should always have a title. So by typing it as a string, I know this is one place where I don't have to worry about null or non-string values anymore. But then again, there are things like our optional publication date where you cannot avoid null, right? So there are a couple of solutions. For one, PHP has special syntax for dealing with null. There's the null coalescing operator and the null safe operator. Both help you get rid of much of these boring null checks. But remember, we had two problems with null, and the problem of having to write null checks, which null coalescing and null safe operators help in solving. But there's also the increased cognitive load, the uncertainty about whether you're dealing with null or not. And our null operators don't really help in solving that problem. You still have to think about it. So the only way to get rid of that nagging question of is this variable null or not is by getting rid of null. There are two ways of doing so in PHP. When you move to other languages, there are other ways as well, but we'll focus on PHP here. So the first solution is the null object pattern. Instead of our publication date being null or a datetime object, we say it will always be a datetime object. Well, actually, I'm going to introduce an interface here because I don't want to deal with all that functionality included in datetime. So let's say we have a blog post date and it has one method, format. It could grow over time, but in our case, one method is enough. And so let's provide two implementations of this interface, an unknown date and a publication date. Both implement the same interface, but for unknown date, the format function will simply return an empty string, because that is the behavior we want in case there's no publication date yet. We want to show an empty string. And then there's the publication date. It wraps a datetime object and it will return a specific format for it. With this blog post date interface and its two implementations, we've created a richer and more accurate version of what null represents in this context. And from the point of view of our blog post, null is gone. We have the same interface, the same methods, whether we're dealing with an actual date or not. But you might have already seen a problem here. In reality, our blog post doesn't live on its own. It most likely comes from a database where there's a table for blog posts with a field for our publication date, which would still be nullable. So we didn't really get rid of null, we just pushed it away further from our code. And now we need a way to convert that null value from our database to an unknown date object in our code. So this is important to realize when trying to get rid of null. You probably won't be able to get rid of it entirely. But let's go back to our initial problem. We want to reduce that feeling of doubt when writing code. And by moving null away to the very edge of our code, in this case, it would be the data mapper of whatever framework we're using, at least we've made sure that we don't have to worry about it when using our blog post objects. Now, it could be worth pushing null away even further. If you're doing lots of database queries and don't want to worry about null in them either, you could think about abstracting it away from the database level as well, probably by making significant changes to your database schema. But you should consider whether it's worth the effort. So that's the null object pattern. Let's take a look at the other solution. This one takes it a couple of steps further. In essence, we don't have one type of blog post. We have a draft and a published post. And it turns out there are some differences between the two. So you could choose to design these two types of blog posts as separate models, a draft blog post and a published blog post. Now, the draft version simply doesn't have a publication date, so there can't be any doubt on whether a field is null or not. It simply isn't there anymore. Now, if you take a minute to think about this solution, you will probably come up with a couple of caveats. That's because this approach doesn't really work in your average CRUD application. It's just too much code for little benefit. But on the other hand, if you're going for a domain-driven approach, where your application state is managed by aggregates, it becomes much easier to manage these several representations of the same thing, like with a draft blog post and published blog post. All of this might seem like a lot of overhead, creating null objects, maybe even changing your model structure. But I want to ask you something. Open a recent project of yours and search for how many times you've used the null coalescing and null safe operator, or maybe just plain isset calls and conditions for null. So every one of those occurrences has been a decision point when you were writing that code. It required you to think about whether there was a possibility of null here. It had you on guard. Now imagine you wouldn't need to be on guard about null anymore. At least not within the major part of your code base. I wouldn't say that's overhead. It would save you time and decrease cognitive load. I believe it's worth thinking about these small details when programming. On its own, the problem with null might seem like something small, but scale it towards real-life production projects, and it might be worth giving it some attention. So with all of that being said, let me know what you think about null in the comments below. And when you're down there, leave a like and subscribe if you're not subscribed yet. Thanks for watching. See you next time.